question is based on teaching of Sri Ramana Maharshi. God's grace is required for a person to make progress in the path of spirituality. So also the Upanishads say that I am God. Does it mean that my grace is required for me to make path in progress in the path of spirituality? This is the question. Here you have to understand that an individual is somebody who has identified with the body and mind. Once consciousness identifies with the body and mind, there's a limitation. I feel very limited as an individual. And I find a very big universe in front of me and I feel separate from the universe. And also because of religious conditioning, social conditioning, or what I hear from others, or what my own assumption, I feel there is God. So there are three aspects here: Jiva, Jagat, and Ishvara. Ishvara means God. For a person who is identified with the body, this is a deep reality. The body, the world, I am the individual, Jiva, and there is a Jagat, which is the world, and there is Ishvara or Bhagavan or the Lord who is controlling this world. This is the reality. This is the experiential reality, and you cannot deny that reality. Okay. Now, the Jiva, the individual, keeps searching for searching for happiness in the world and avoids suffering in the world. This is our general direction. And nature is such that everything in the world keeps changing. The goalposts keep moving. So, which means the person will never be able to feel happy, fully contented by what is available in the world. And he may go through tremendous amount of suffering also. And most of the people as individuals, somewhere the other way, they believe in God and they pray to God. They don't know that the God and they are one. Okay. There's a sense of duality for the person. Now that being the case, he starts seeking the help of God. Seeking guidance from the God to get out of suffering. And he starts surrendering to God in terms of bhakti yoga and karma yoga. So there is a separation from the God because there is ego. Because of the ego. Ego separates you from God. Okay. When Vedanta says you are one with God, you are one with God, you recognize your oneness with God when ego is dropped. Till that point of time, you are separate from God only because you have a feeling of separation. You cannot be one with God until you drop the separation from the God. And you have built a wall is built between you and God in the form of ego. Until the ego dissolves, God is separate, world is separate, and you are separate. And that's the reality. Right? It's like saying a person with a cataract. For him, we say the world is beautiful. Okay? Yeah, world may be beautiful, but he is not able to see the world because of the cataract. Until cataract has to be operated upon, he cannot see the world, beautiful world. Similarly, the ego has to be operated upon. Ego has to be dissolved before you can realize oneness with God. Until that, you are feeling deeply separate. Okay? So then the totality of existence is God for you, and that's the God. So that God has to give a grace you. The first grace comes in the form of nature. Nature will keep pushing you for more and more happiness, and it'll always make sure that happiness is, you cannot get permanent happiness. It keeps shifting the goal. Okay. So basically nature keeps a hide and seek of game of happiness and causes suffering for you as you keep looking for happiness. So that way nature, which is actually nothing but a manifestation of God only, pushes you towards God. There's a grace. Okay. So then you pray to God that show me the path, and you do karma yoga and bhakti yoga practices, which will help you to refine your ego from tamasic and rajasic ego to sattvic ego. At that point of time, still the wisdom is not there. I am one with God. So that wisdom is missing. So then God himself will come in the form of Guru. That's why it is said, Ishwaro Guru Atmeti. This is the step for anybody. First, person worships Guru, Ishwara, Lord. Then, Lord will appear in the form of Guru, Sadguru. And he gives the teaching of Atmadhyana. Then you realize oneness with self. Okay? You are already one with self. But since you don't feel it, don't experience it because of the ego, the grace has to come from the totality called God. Okay? So that way, the grace of the God has to be there for self-realization, because you have a sense of separation from God. If you didn't have a sense of separation from God, why will you do anyway spiritual sadhana or anything? All spiritual sadhana will drop. Then there's no question of self-realization. So the question of self-realization is coming because you have a separation from God, which you have ego. That means there's a grace required. Okay.